Jean Desmet's Dream Factory is the current exhibition at the iFilm Museum. The Amsterdam Film Show spoke with some of the staff behind the exhibition to find out more.
Jean Desmet's Dream Factory is the newest exhibition in I, and it's here from until April the 12th. And we show around 57 short films that were collected by Jean Desmet. Jean Desmet was a distributor of film somewhere between 1906 and 1916.
Well, I hold the complete collection of Jean Desmet, given to us by the family Desmet. And this is a very compact but nice collection. It's like time travel, basically, because it shows us many things about how films were distributed, shown, but also made in a way in that period. Although Jean Desmet was a distributor and theater owner, so he never made a film, but he bought them for the Dutch market and he distributed them and he kept them.
This is what makes the Desmet collection quite unique, because it's not only about the films. It also contains a lot of posters, about 1,000 posters, original from that time, so they're all vintage materials, and also other publicity material from that time. And of course, also interesting part is the company papers. We have files and files of company papers, since Jean Desmet never threw anything away. This company paper shows us today how the business was conducted in these days. And it contains bills, for example, but even, I don't know, letters, many letters, in fact, and drafts of telegrams that he sent. Sometimes he had to send a telegram in three languages to different countries about one and the same film. He kept catalogs that he was given to choose films from. He made calculations in the margins about maybe asking for discounts, actually very regularly asking for discounts to the distributors. So there is so much to learn from. It's an incredible source, not only for film history, but also for generally speaking about doing business and economics, international relations, and so on.
Jean Desmet was a pioneering film distributor, not only for the Netherlands but for the world. He was among the first film distributors. In a way, he's one of those who found out what film distribution must be, because he started out as a fairground attraction exploiter, and then he went on to have his own cinemas, in fact steady film theaters. And then he realized that if you have a film theater, then you have to have films to show there. And this is where he felt the necessity to buy films and rent films. Actually, the collection consists only of non-Dutch films, because Jean Desmet bought his films abroad. About one third of the films are French films, and then followed by many Italian, German, American films. And these films actually have disappeared in their country of origin. So today, we are the only institute in the world to hold these films, and we collaborate very often, actually, with these countries to restore the films, for example. And when they're looking for something, they come to us.
Why I like the collection so very much is that everything that you see was made by a pioneer. So there were no rules, there was no idea about acting before the camera or doing establishing shots or making close-ups. So all these rules were not there. They were inventing the language of cinema, and this is what makes it so unique and so special. And this is something that we can still learn from, to watch with fresh new eyes to this medium.
Another film that I really love, which is also in the exhibition, is Acque Miracolose, which starts with a puppet dollhouse kind of setting, which is actually quite revolutionary. Yeah, very beautiful to see. Basically, before the First World War, film was a very young medium still, and it was a novelty in itself. And people were fascinated by its technology, by the mere fact of the possibility of capturing motion and playing it back was the novelty. So the way today we are fascinated by the iPhones and so on, they were fascinated by the film as a phenomenon. So they went to the cinema without necessarily knowing which film was showing, but just because going to the cinema was a thing to do. And in this respect also, like, the films were not
compartmental as they are today. So there were no children's films specially made for children. There were no films made specially for this purpose or showing this and that. No, the whole thing is, you know, about going to the cinema and seeing something that is worth seeing.
Yeah, not it doesn't even have to be a story. Yeah. If you would have a beautiful mountain with clouds that were moving, also that was already fantastic.
You just see a beautiful flower and it's turning. Mm-hmm. And it's the only thing that's happening. So it's really like you have a beautiful moving painting on the wall. So now maybe in the visual arts you will see this.
Yeah, but absolutely.
Not in a regular cinema for a wider audience.
A lot of it is fiction, but about one third is non-fiction.
Yeah. And still, this is very diverse. We have scientific films, but we have animations, we have travelogues.
Yeah. The genres back then were also different. They are not the genres as we know them, because the program was constituted by different parts. As I said, newsreels, for example, were part of the program. So we have the newsreels from 1915. And all the films are mainly from 1906 to 1916, maybe we should say, when he stopped his business, basically. Because of the First World War, the economic situation changed, the transport of the films became difficult, because if you realize that he was buying films from United States and France and Germany and Denmark, this became economically and politically more difficult. Yeah. So he decided that he would stop.
Well, the name Jean Desmet's Dream Factory, we wanted to convey this moment in time in cinema where anything was possible, where the illusion of images were something to get very excited about, basically, that it created a new way for the people to see the world and to dream about, and things that they, I think we could also say it's the start of the visual culture. This period is the start of visual culture as we know it today, because before then they only maybe read books in which there were illustrations, newspapers contained only very few images actually, and suddenly being able to see so many real life images.
Jean Desmet's Dream Factory is on at iFilm Museum until the 12th of April. For more information, see ifilm.nl.